there you are.
I am busy, Alan.
I wanted to talk to you about last night, Monica. This is the first chance that I've had.
Good.
It's just that I just want you to know that I just hate being told by my wife to keep my hands off her when all I'm trying to do is be affectionate with you. I mean, I'm still your husband.
Alan, when I want my husband to maul me, I'll let my husband know that.
Dr. Citrano, call emergency receiving code blue.
Dr. Citrano,
call emergency receiving code blue.
It's just that I need you.
Oh, Alan, I'm sorry. Is every nurse in General Hospital wised up to you?
Does this mean you're not going to work with us against Donnelly? Because there's an awful lot we still don't know about that merger.
Relax, my dear. I am still on your side, out of bed anyway.
Well, that's a start.
As a matter of fact, I had breakfast with Sean today. And there's something up. Something rather big.
Any idea what?
When I find out, you will be the next to know.
Volunteer with a wheelchair to the ninth floor nurses' station staff. Volunteer with a wheelchair to...
Monica, where have you been all day?
Where have I been all day? Where else would I be? At the hospital.
What, working all day?
Yes, of course. I mean, you knew that. Where have you been all day, Alan?
Well, it was my day off, Monica, remember? And I've been here waiting to hear from you.
What are you talking about? You knew this morning I was going to be at the hospital.
I don't mean that, Monica. I'm talking about what have you accomplished with Donnelly?
What?
You do know that Dimitri Cassadine is in town, and he's talking to Donnelly. I mean, have you found out why?
I have no idea.
Well, for heaven's sake, why don't you have any idea? I mean, you do speak to Donnelly. I mean, you are speaking to the man, aren't
you? Alan, I have been busy all day long doing what I do to make a living. That is practicing medicine. I am not a full-time spy for you and Edward, and I am damn tired of you trying to treat me like that.
Look, Monica, you know how important this business is, and you've
got to
stop.
Yes, I know how important it is to you and Edward, but I will not be cross-examined or ordered around like a trained dog.
I thought I heard your voice.
You could hear it from a block away.
What's the problem?
Oh, I'm so glad you're all home. I'll tell Stella to start dinner.
Nothing for me, Lara, thank you.
Nothing? Well, you're not ill, are you, dear?
No, Mother, she's just very tired. She's been in OR all day.
Oh, I'm sorry. Well, perhaps you'll have an appetite after you have a nice, long, hot bath. Hmm?
Well, as I was saying, what is the problem?
Well, Alan told you, Edward, I am tired, that's all.
Good Lord, Monica, we're all tired, but what happened about Donnelly and Cassadine?
It's a very touchy subject tonight, Father.
Touchy? Why?
Because I did not feel like playing Matt Hari today, that's why.
Well, hello, all.
Hello, Celia.
Celia, we were just talking about Cassadine. Did you have any luck today?
Yes, I did. I made an excuse to go over and see Sean, and I met the very charming Mr. Cassadine.
You did?
Well, good girl. What did he say?
Well, he said that he had met Jimmy Lee in Sao Paulo and that they had had dinner together, which gave me the perfect opportunity to invite him to a dinner party with us.
Well, I'm glad one member of the distaff side of this family is functioning today.
When did you invite him to come?
Well, I didn't set a date yet, but he'll be in Port Charles for at least a week.
Well, good. Let's go in here and make some plans, huh?
Absolutely. This is going to be the party to end all parties with a feast to fit the king.
Yes.
Or at least a Cassadine.
You coming, Monica?
No. You're going to have to plan the party. By yourselves. I'm going to take Lana's advice and go up and take a bath. Good night.
Hi.
Hi. Home at last.
Long day?
Well, Rick and I spent a good portion of it working on a car accident victim, and I'm sorry for that woman. She's in bad shape.
Well, this party tonight will get your mind off your job.
Oh.
Should turn out to be some evening. We're finally going to get to meet Dimitri Cassadine. Celia tells me he's quite a character.
Well, not tonight.
Oh, come on, Monica. It'll be fun.
Well, you enjoy yourself. If you could keep the noise down, I'd appreciate it. You know I am a light sleeper.
Come on, you can't pass on this one, please.
Watch me.
Monica. For the family's sake, please. Look, I realize I haven't been that attentive to you lately.
Really? I hadn't noticed.
Really, I'm very sorry for spending so much time in this Cassadine plan, but I'm doing it for us.
Rationalization's a wonderful thing, isn't it?
No, it's not a rationalization. I mean, if you and I manage to engineer this financial coup, certainly it'll, well, help us to forget some of our past differences, won't it?
You want to know something?
Huh?
I doubt there is a snowball's chance in hell that we could become husband and wife again. Oh. Lila, scared me.
Don't you think you were a bit rough on him, dear?
Look, Lila, you don't know the whole story, okay?
No, but I do know that Alan is a good man. Oh, he gets a little lost sometimes and worries about things that are not important, but at heart, he's well worth the effort.
Lila, it isn't as if I haven't tried.
I know you have, dear. I know you have as well as anyone. But Alan's struggle is with his father, not with you. You see, he wants more than anything else to prove that he's worthy of the Quartermain name.
Yes, I realize that. It's just, see, I don't know how much compassion I have left in me.
More than you suspect, I imagine. Love dies a lot more slowly than it grows.
What are you saying, Lila? What are you, I'm supposed to just ignore all his faults?
No, dear. No, just that you'll consider your alternatives very, very carefully. Life is difficult enough, my dear, without abandoning the security of a happy marriage. Do you think that you're really ready to re-enter the ranks of the singles as a new recruit?
May I ask you something?
Oh, whatever happened to good morning? How are you?
Oh, yes, that too. I'm sorry.
Well, I'm all right. Just no more, no less.
What are you talking about?
It doesn't matter. It's not important.
So what happened to you after our honored guest left last night?
Well, as I recall, I came in to tell you I was going to bed and said goodnight.
Did you?
Well, you and Edward were talking business, so I doubt if you even heard me.
Oh, dear. I'm sorry. I guess I should apologize.
No, don't. Not if it's a strain.
Monica, really, I'm sorry, and I certainly want to tell you how much I appreciate you doing your bit with Cassadine last night.
My bit?
Yeah, I mean, throwing your drink over his jacket. It gave us a chance to get those assay papers out of his pocket. I must say, the man was really bedazzled by you.
You know, I wonder if Lila would have done something like that.
Mother?
Well, yes, Lila, your mother.
She's a true Quartermain woman, you know.
You have become a monumental bore.
I beg your pardon?
A bore. A very big bore. Your only interest is money, corporate takeovers.
Wait a minute. You think I want the money for myself?
Oh, yes.
No. You're wrong. I want the money for our family, for our sons, and especially for you.
Oh, well, you were doing fine until you included me.
Wait a minute. When you married me, you wanted wealth, Monica. I thought that I was doing exactly what you wanted.
What I wanted? What I would want, Alan, what I've always wanted, is communication. We don't have that. Unless I am willing to talk about money with you, we have nothing to talk about at all anymore.
You're building up to something, aren't you?
Oh, how did you guess?
Sorry, lady. I don't want a confrontation. I am not going to let you spoil last night's success. Now, I'm going to the hospital. Are you coming?
I will take my car.
Fine. I'll see you there. May I join you?
You just have.
You know, driving in, I was thinking about us.
Good.
I'm at a loss about your attitude, Monica.
I'm not. My attitude gets clearer every minute.
Could we take a step back for a moment, please?
No, Alan, I think that's the wrong direction.
If you recall, we had a talk, Monica, about us trying to make our marriage work.
Oh, Alan, we've had many talks. Which one are you referring to?
I'm referring to the talk where we had where we might try sleeping together again. I'm certainly willing.
You're always willing.
We both have needs physically. Let's try sleeping together, maybe once a week or something like that. I mean, let's make an effort toward each other. It might ease the tension between the two of us, don't you think?
What do you suggest? We just make an appointment with each other?
Why are you being so sarcastic?
Oh, am I?
Look, Monica, please, this is important. Have you lost all interest in me physically?
Oh, okay, wait a minute, pal. We haven't even gotten to that area yet.
You know what? If you had any class, I wouldn't even have to request your company in bed.
Class? Class? You go out and have an affair with Susan Moore and bring home an illegitimate child and want me to raise it?
How did we get to that?
Class, buddy. We were talking about class. This clinical lovemaking. You are so off base, I cannot believe it.
Look, only this morning we were talking about communication.
I'll tell you what the ultimate blow was. It was last night. It was last night when I set you up. I did everything for you, and you ignored me. You just kissed me off. The thing, I came in to say goodnight, and you didn't even know why I existed.
I am very grateful to you, Monica, and I told you for all the help that you've given us in the Cassadine-Donnelly merger. And I assure you that once we bought into it, you'll have more power and money than you ever dreamed of. You should be grateful.
And that should be enough for me, shouldn't it?
Yes!
Oh, I was just looking for you.
I was saying goodnight to the Boers.
Oh. Well, I wanted to know what you'd like to have for dinner.
Oh, I don't care. I mean, whatever everybody else is having.
Oh, well, that's just it. There's no one else here.
What do you mean? Where's Lila?
Oh, well, Mrs. Quartermain went out to dinner with her bridge group. Oh. She told me to ask you if you'd like to join them.
No, thank you, no. I'm not in the mood for bridge tonight, I think.
She thought you might be lonely.
Well, where's Alan?
Oh, he and Mr. Quartermain went to the club to have dinner, you know, to discuss business.
Oh, certainly to discuss business.
There's several things I can fix just for you.
No, I'm not really that hungry, Stella. And if I do get hungry, I'm sure I can fix something for myself.
Are you sure?
I am sure. So why don't you just call it a day?
Oh, well, thank you. I might at that.
Good.
There's lots in the refrigerator.
I'm going to be fine. Don't you worry.
I do worry about you, you know.
I do know. Thank
Sometimes you. This house is just too big.
And too lonely.